So let's see, I've done a couple of changes. One is I went to a 6x6 grid. So instead of doing just 1, 2, 3x3, it does 6x6. And let's see, I downloaded a calibration model here for bed leveling. I stopped the print after one layer. I think some of these got I was starting to print a second layer over there. I think I still have the sensor a little too close, or actually I have it, I need to raise it a little bit more because these things are sticking pretty solid. Now this was probably the first one, so it might not have been extruding all the way. This was probably the second one. Yeah, these are still, they are like really stuck down. Yeah, I think I'm still a little bit close to the bed. So what I may want to do here is I'm going to turn the sensor probably another eighth of a turn clockwise. I've got to check my instructions here. So it says if the filament is smushed, rotate 1/4 turn clockwise. I did about an eighth of a turn last night. I may go another eighth to get that quarter turn, because what that's going to do, if you do that, quarter turn clockwise lowers the sensor, which means it's going to detect the bed earlier, and that raises the nozzle. So I think that'll be my next step here, because all of these are stuck down quite well. Okay, try to second print here. I changed the height a little bit. I think I might have gone too far. You can see I'm getting a problem sticking there. Yeah, I might have to go back counterclockwise a little bit. Let's see what some of these look like here. There's like the front. Yeah, that peels up a little too easy. Yeah, that's a little too much. So it looks like I'm getting pretty close. Yeah, you can see how those are really almost not sticking. They're just barely held down. And that back one, boy, that wasn't even stuck. So I guess I went too far. Okay, here's the third try. I lowered the nozzle a little bit. It sticks pretty good and it looks fairly full. Let's try one of these back here. Yeah, I think that's looking pretty good. Sticking down pretty good. I guess that one's a little rough surface, but I guess the bottoms look pretty good. The tops feel a little bit rough, but I think they're okay. They're definitely stuck down well, but not insanely hard like sometimes. That is definitely adhered to the bed. Yeah, just a few little holes like right down right in there. But yeah, I think everything's pretty uniform. They're either completely filled in like that one. Well, there's like just a slight void right there around the edge, but all of them are very similar. You wouldn't be able to tell which one came from where. Yeah, I think that's a pretty good setup right there. So yeah, it took about 3 or 4 adjustments. So we'll wrap this up for now. So I'm doing the auto bed leveling bilinear feature, and I've programmed in a 6x6 test array. So that's actuated when you do the G29 G-code command. That's in the start G code in the Cura slicer. So there's already a G29 in there, which basically says do the auto bed leveling. And so the only thing I do beforehand is I turn on the bed heat, turn that on, leave it on for about 10 minutes to make sure everything warms up and any thermal expansion is going to happen. And I do notice a difference. I'll show you in Excel. I put the cold and hot correction meshes into Excel, and then I have a spreadsheet and a chart that shows the cold, the hot, and then also the difference. So let's go take a look at that and see what that looks like.
Okay, let's take a look at this bilinear bed leveling mesh data. That's quite a mouthful. So I showed you in the previous video where I captured this data out of the Octoprint terminal window after running the G29 bed leveling command. So what I had done first was I used a cold bed and ran the G29 command, captured this data, and then I showed you capturing the data off of the hot bed. So this bed was warmed up to 90 degrees C for about 15 minutes and produced this mesh. And you can see there's a difference between the two. Things definitely moved around a bit. So this was the first trial with bilinear bed leveling using the default 3x3 mesh, which gives you 9 samples. So then I changed the mesh size from 3x3 up to a 6x6 mesh, which gives you 36 height samples here. And then I repeated that same test. Here I did a cold bed. Then the second array was again with the bed heated up to 90 C. And then what I did for this third array, I did an array difference. So I took the hot data minus the cold data and computed a third array. So here is the difference. So I had hot minus cold, and that's the difference. And that's how much the bed moves once you heat it up. And again, this was to 90 C. Definitely moves around, so one lesson learned there is definitely if you're using bed leveling and you're using a heated bed, heat the bed up for a good 10 to 15 minutes. So anyway, this was with the 6x6 bilinear, and that's what I was using earlier in this video. And then there's one other option down in that section of the configuration.h file. They call it bilinear subdivision. And you can see with the 6x6 points, you've got 36 grid points. That leaves 5 rows and 5 columns of meshes. And then that subdivision then takes each one of these mesh sections here and divides it into a further 3x3 sections. You start with a 5x5 mesh or 6x6 points, and you end up with a 15x15 mesh or 16x16 points. So these points here are all computed. These points here are measured. And you can see here some of the original data is still there. Here's a 0.34, 0.34, here's a 0.21, 0.21. So what they do when you turn on that subdivision option is the comment mentions that they do this Catmull ROM spline interpolation. And that was a technique developed in the mid-70s by Edwin Catmull and Raphael Rom. And what it does, this shows a 2D representation of that, is you get your control points. Those are your measured mesh points that you sample with the proximity sensor, and then you fit a spline curve to those points. And as it mentions here, the spline passes through the control points, and then the spline is continuous, and the C1 I think means it's continuous at the first derivative, which means there are no discontinuities in the tangent direction and magnitude. So if we look at that here, you can see here we came up this slope here, and then there's a hard bend, and there's all these bumps and points and folds in the surface. So the idea is with this interpolation, you smooth all those out. And I think this is about as far as you can go. I tried bumping the code up to a 7x7 grid, and the Arduino IDE gave me a linker time warning that the program memory was dangerously low and the program might become unstable. So I went back to the 6x6 bilinear with the 3x3 subdivision, And I think that's a reasonable compromise. Going from the 3x3 to the 6x6, you're going from 9 sample points to 36. So this process here takes 4 times as long to do because you're probing 36 points instead of 9. But then you're computing 256 points from that original 36 points. So it's likely that you could actually do a 16x16 sampling without doing the subdivision. You could just go and probe that, but that's going to take forever because you're doing 16 rows and 16 columns of probing. So this way you're only doing 4 times as much sampling as you did in the 3x3 case, and then you're computing this 16x16 array of points. And this has been working very well. I've had really excellent bed adhesion. And if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below, and I'll put some follow-up videos over here on the left side. And as always, thanks for watching.